हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू चैनल नीट। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद द चैप्टर दैट इज नोन एज बायोलॉजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन। ओके, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद लेक्चर नंबर 5। ओके, इन द प्रीवियस वीडियोस वी हैव कवर्ड द टॉपिक रिगार्डिंग आर्टिफिशियल सिस्टम ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन एंड वी हैव कवर्ड द टॉपिक अबाउट नेचुरल सिस्टम ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन। इन टुडेज टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू सी द फाइलोजेनेटिक सिस्टम ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन। इन फाइलोजेनेटिक सिस्टम ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन वी आर गोइंग टू सी द वर्क ऑफ आइकलर, एंगलर, हचिंगसन एंड तख्ताचन। दीज आर द 4 मेजर इंपॉर्टेंट साइंटिस्ट विच वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड अंडर फाइलोजेनेटिक क्लासिफिकेशन। ओके, सो लेट्स लर्न लाइव। सो नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द फाइलोजेनेटिक सिस्टम ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन। Phylogenetic system of classification. So let us now see the history behind the phylogenetic system. Okay, now as you already know, Charles Darwin has given theory of evolution and the preservation of races in the struggle of life. So Charles Darwin was the first who gave us the theory of evolution. Okay, this was one book, The Preservation of Races in Struggle of Life. This was the
concept of the book.
The Preservation of Races of Struggle of Life was published in 1859. So many scientists have taken the reference of Charles Darwin for explaining the phylogenetic system, since he was the one who has given us the theory of evolution, okay, and also the struggle of existence. Okay, let's move to the next point. Phylogenetic system was introduced by August Wilhelm Eichler in 1883. Phylogenetic system was proposed by Engler and Prandtl. Phylogenetic system was modified or improved by Hutchinson and Takhtajan. So these are the scientists involved behind the discovery of phylogenetic system of classification, where Charles Darwin has played an important role for giving us theory of evolution, okay, which is one of the basis of phylogenetic system of classification. Okay, fine. So we'll quickly revise the history of phylogenetic system of classification. So since Charles Darwin has written the books Theory of Evolution, okay, Origin of Species, okay, we could get an concept where we could able to relate the organism to its ancestor. Now this particular discovery was again put forward by August Wilhelm Eichler in 1883. Okay, it was proposed by Engler and Prandtl. Okay, and there were improvement and modification that was done by Hutchinson and Takhtajan. So now we'll start with the characteristics of phylogenetic system of classification. So phylogenetic system is one of the latest system of classification. It is done on micro scale . The goal for introduction of phylogenetic system was finding the evolutionary basis. The source that was taken for finding out the evolutionary basis was the fossil, and in fossil there were majoritically bones. So bones was one of the fossil through which we could identify the evolutionary basis or the developmental pattern. Phylogenetic system of classification ignored morphological similarity and differences. They did not take this point into consideration. Let's see the next point. If animals belong to same taxa, they have common ancestor. Example: lion, tiger. So they have a common ancestor. Let's see the next point. Takhtajan has given a very important statement. Taxonomy without phylogeny is like bone without flesh. So these are some important points that we should know regarding the phylogenetic system. We'll quickly revise. It is one of the latest system. It was done on micro scale, mean minute things were observed. The goal of the phylogenetic system was the evolutionary basis to find out the common ancestor. Okay, and for that they have chosen the bone as the record or fossil, but there was the limitation of it, okay, and this is highly dynamic. Dynamic, okay, fine. There are possibilities as the discovery are going to happen, okay. Phylogenetic system of classification and it content might vary, therefore the word dynamic. It is not a stable classification, okay. They have ignored the morphological character and the similarities, okay. That was the basis of artificial system of classification, so they have ignored it out, okay. Now they say that if the animal is belonging to same taxa, okay, they will be having a common ancestor, so they might have a common ancestor, so this becomes very important, okay, fine. Now very important statement by Takhtajan, okay, he said taxonomy without phylogeny is of no use. It is of no use. There has to be a relationship to each and every organism, okay. So this was an introduction with respect to phylogenetic system of classification. Now we'll see each and every scientist in detail.
Hope you like today's video. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.